Laundrie's remains were found in a Florida nature preserve last month, 1 month after Petito, 22, was found strangled to death on the edge of Wyoming's Grand Teton National Park, where the couple had been traveling together in a van. The 23-year-old was named a person of interest in the case after he returned to his parents' home in Florida alone in early September, then disappeared himself. Petito's parents reported her missing on 11th of September, 3 days before Laundrie's family claimed he left their house in Northport with a backpack but left behind his wallet and cell phone. The initial coroner's report on Laundrie, issued soon after his skeletal remains were discovered in the swampy Miocohatchee Creek Environmental Park, was inconclusive. On Tuesday, Stephen Bertolino, attorney for Laundrie's parents, announced they had now received a more detailed report after the remains were sent to a forensic anthropologist. Chris and Roberta are still mourning the loss of their son and are hopeful that these findings bring closure to both family. Laundrie was never charged in connection with Petito's death, but a federal arrest warrant was issued by a court in Wyoming on 24th of September after a grand jury indicted him for the unauthorized use of a debit card which Petito's family say was hers. FBI investigators have been searching for clues and belongings found near Laundrie's body, including a water-damaged notebook. The FBI has yet to release any statement on the progress of its investigation. The hunt for Petito, who was recording the couple's cross-country adventures on social media, and then the search for Laundrie, captured the nation's attention. Police in Moab City, Utah, released body cam footage recorded on 12th of August of officers speaking with the couple after receiving a domestic violence call. In the video, a tearful Petito is seen admitting the pair had fought, with officers eventually separating them for the night, Laundrie going to a hotel. Laundrie is seen telling the officers, who controversially concluded that Petito was the aggressor, that they had a minor scuffle and he did not want to pursue a domestic violence charge. "I'm not going to pursue anything because she is my fiancée and I love her," he says. "It was just a squabble. Sorry it had to get so public." It was the last known recording of Laundrie and Petito together. Northport police investigating Laundrie's disappearance said the family refused to speak with detectives, which Bertolino later said was on his advice.